All right, fellas, so we back. We finna get this new Forever Sharp steering wheel installed in Lucille. I got all my tools laid out and stuff. Try to get it knocked out pretty quick for y'all. That's what I love to do. I love to get stuff done, love doing upgrades and stuff. So I hope y'all enjoy the video. All right, fellas, so this is what we working with. This is the wheel adapter. It's a 5/6 hole, and it can be used on 69 through 94 GM cars and 74 through 94 GM trucks. And this is the horn button. And that is the part number for it. The steering wheel. I've seen a lot of people, this is a pretty popular steering wheel, but I haven't seen nobody with this exact one on YouTube or nothing, so that's the part number. And this is the tools that I got laid out. I got my steering wheel lock plate removal tool. I got a wrench, a 3/8 drives, a couple of extensions, some Allen keys, and a couple of sockets. I got a pick, a flat, and a couple of flat blade screwdrivers. So let's get to it, fellas. And this is the turn signal cam. I hope y'all can see that, what I was talking about. That's the part number that I'm gonna put in also. We're gonna pop this horn button off. And we got 3 hex bolts and a shaft nut right there. The shaft got an indention on it, and you need that pointing straight up. So I already got that pointing straight up, and I already disconnected my battery. So we're gonna go on and pop these hex bolts out. This is what I like to do, fellas, right here. Wrenching. I don't play no video games or none of that. That's what I do. We're gonna get that shaft nut off next. Sucker pop right on. Damn, put that back there. Take that off. And I need to get my steering wheel puller to get that off. And this is what I call convoluted bullshit, but you gotta do what you gotta do. But it is tedious. Just gotta get everything lined up. Just try your best. Get it on the first try. But it don't work that way too often, but. That's why I call it convoluted bullshit. I'm just gonna tighten this up and down. It should pop right out for me. Just like that. All that for that. Alright. Now we got our lock plate. And it's a clip down there. That's why you gotta use the tool to push it down and spring load. You push it down, you gotta fish that clip out with a pick. I'm gonna get to that. make sure it's just straight and flush as possible. That's why I use my wrench. Sucker down till you get that cup exposed. And you can fish it out. I already see it basically. Alright, that's pretty good. You get your pick. And this is kind of tedious too, but kind of fish it out there. I use a flat blade and a pick to kind of get it and start walking it out. Fishing that sucker out of there. Just walk it up the shaft. And then we're gonna loosen that back. Oh crap. Let's see how we're gonna do this. That thing broke off. Let me get some vice grips and see if I can loosen that. These are some cheap AutoZone tools, about 20 bucks, so I'm not sweating that it broke. I just hope I can get it on. If there's a will, there's a way. You know what I mean? What you can do, just get that clip, walk it the rest of the way off the shaft. And that's the little clip. And your lock plate comes off. And that's the infamous turn signal cam. And what it does, what it does, those little indentions sit into the turn signal switch, and when you turn the wheel, them springs right there, they hit it, and that's what cancels out your turn signal. It's pretty clever. It's that simple. Gotta love 80s engineering. Another one. Just pop right in there. Gotta repeat the process. Get the clip, make sure you get the clip back on the shaft before you start. looks perfect. Just want to make sure when you're going down that it's kind of straight on there, flush. Check it every now and then. Get it. Make sure I ain't nothing binding or nothing. When I feel it bottom out, that's when I start walking that clip back down the shaft. And it's a little groove, you can see it. It's about there, about one more turn. I can walk it down there. Flat blade to just push it in place. You'll hear it click. Now you just unloosen it. That's on there. Next, the adapter. So we gotta put that horn wire in. That's the horn wire. Let's get that popped up. What you'll do, it comes with a wire, a spring, and a little plastic piece that'll lock into the turn signal cam. And all you do, you get your wire, and it's like a little barrel in the end. That's the end you want to put down in the turn signal cam. And that goes up to the lead on your horn button with the spade connector on there. You just get that, you just put that on there. And you put your spring down there. Push it down, and boom, that's on there. All right, you got your column cover, your spacer, and your adapter. This the spacer, this the adapter. This goes on first, and it's got an indention. If you need the angle, move it over, move your horn wire over to this side, or have it coming out this side. It has that indention in there, so that's pretty cool. But what you want to do is line the hose up. Let's see. Because you see, it should be like that. Yeah, where it goes to the top. So I'm going to get it lined up either in that direction. I think it'll go exactly like that. And that top one should line up with that shaft indention. But let's see. So put the horn wire lead through and it fits on there. And they see it. If it's rubbing up against there, it's a little spacer ring right here that you can put in there. But, or if it has a spring, but I don't think that I need it. Let me see. Just use it, fellas. I didn't think I needed it. Well, no, it ain't going all the way down. I don't need it. I see it. I got bad eyes, so it takes me a while to see the stuff. So,
all right, I'm gonna put the wire in.
All right, fellas, we back.
Let's finish her up. So, you might have to put the horn wire in that groove and put a piece of tape on it. So it'll, the horn, the steering wheel line up. Let's see. I need the column cover. Let's see if this will work first. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna have to do. I'm gonna have to put a piece of tape on there. Get it in. Make sure it's down in there. And it is. Spring back down in there.
I just need it to hold in place while I get it on there.
I think that'll work. I'll put one little piece in there just for safekeeping. Column cover on there, we're gonna put it through the overhaul. And we're just gonna line up those holes as they line up. And now, that's the top. Put that in. It's probably the hardest part, getting the hose to line up. I want that hole to be right there to be straight up, but I'm gonna go on and put these hex bolts in there and you're gonna see. Thank you. kind of convoluted bullshit too. You just gotta get it lined up, but once you get it lined up, it should be fairly simple, I guess. All right. I want that top hole to line up with the top. Let's see. Just gotta get everything lined up. One more. Fellas, we're gonna take it back off and see if I can get it. Get that top hole a little bit adjusted. See what we're working with. I just don't wanna go through everything and put it on and it will be kinda crooked. Put it on that way, the top hole. It's gonna have to go on that way with the little groove. You know, anytime you go work on a car, you can have it planned out. This job gonna take me 45 minutes, and little stuff like this is what drags it out. But you gotta make sure it's perfect, you know what I mean? You just gotta do what you gotta do. That's all right. Make sure you get it done right. No problems in the long run. Alright, this shit I told you, fellas. I'm gonna put that on there. That lines up. That's what I'm getting to. I want that one as top as possible. Straight up at the top as possible. I really want that to line up with that shaft, my indention on the shaft. straight is this gonna get? I wonder. Take a look at the wheel. Hey, yeah, I think that'd be perfect, fellas, because it's locked right now, and it's gonna have a little play in it. I think that'll work. Let's get these back in there. I just had to make sure it's straight, man, because that other one wasn't. It used to bother me. As you can see, it's really not that difficult. It's just kind of tedious, some aspects of it, but it's not hard at all. Not the type of person, like, if somebody can do it, I can do it. You know what I mean? If I research enough and learn enough about it, I feel I can do anything. There's somebody willing to teach you, you know what I mean? When on YouTube, there's so many guys out here that's showing you what to do and how to do it. You just gotta get up and do it. Yeah, you break something, just dig in your pocketbook, fix it, man. That's it. Or dig in your wallet for that matter, not your pocketbook. So I get this on. Not either. I'll put the shaft nut on there. Well, I need to go on and hook up the ground lead for the horn wire on there. I got one of those bolts out. Oh. That should have changed. Oh no, they got it right there. Got a little Phillips head right there. Let me grab me a Phillips head screwdriver out the back, fellas. Alright, so I can go put this last hex in here. And it is a little Phillips head screw you can use to ground it right there. I see it. I'm gonna get these tightened down.
just put the little plug head and spray connector. Or ring turner. That's a little scratch, but you might not be clumsy and lose it. I shake a lot, so this gonna be kinda tedious for me. So that's the best way to do it. I should have put it on there before I did this. Smart. What the hell? I'm just trying to orientate it. I ain't getting away
from anything. That was kind of a task in itself, too, fellas. So just be prepared. I'll put that shaft nut on. It is. I heard that like a retaining clip to go on the outside of it. I ain't have one when I bought the car. I'll probably try to find one online or something. But it ain't gonna come off. Get the steering wheel assembled. Alright, my half wrap. My head's got 5 holes. They come with some little small Allen screws you can bolt it to. So you just gotta line it up. Get your screws. Got some Allen keys right here. I think that, yeah, they give you an extra one just in case you lose one. There's 6 in there. That's pretty cool. I love it when companies do that because I'm the clumsy guy that always drop a screw. And y'all see how bad I shake. I shake and drop it under the seat and never find it again until 6 months down the damn road. I don't know what it is with 10 millimeter sockets. I go buy them, like buy extra ones and still damn lose them. I don't know what it is. All right, we got that all done, so I'm gonna just put that extra screw in there. All right. think what they said is you'll just run one bolt in right now to hold it in, and you'll get your horn together. So that's what we'll do. Just to hold it in place so you won't be having to do both at once. They said it really doesn't matter which one is which, but they say the power is the one closer to the middle, so that's what I'm gonna use. To be honest with you, fellas, you may have to put another one in. This is gonna fit enough. Let's see if I got another. I don't have any more spades, fellas. I looked. I'm just gonna crimp this one on there. I'm just gonna do it that way. Okay. Let me get this. Why it come out like the last one? Get a pull test. I don't use solder. I always use butt connectors and like heat shrink butt connectors. I never seen, all the years I've been working on cars, I never seen from the factory the engineers use solder except for on circuit boards. So that's the only time I use it. I just use a good quality butt connector or put a metric pack or a Delphi connector on there if you want to splice into something. Shift. All right, fellas, we got the horn wire situated. Let's put that on the center now. Make sure it's snugged on there. We're gonna put the black one on the one closer one to the outside. Then I'll tuck those wires in there. I'm gonna take the screw out. Right there. Allen key. Yeah, I think it looks great, fellas. What y'all think? It's a little lighter than that, but it's far better than the other one. I think it still looks good. I'm just running these in and I'll tighten them down in a star pattern. Don't want to strip it out, but you want it tight. Don't do what I just did. Just want to get it tight on there. See on there, fellas. I'm gonna hook up the battery and see if the horn works.
All right, fellas, there she is. What y'all think? I think it look pretty sleek in here, man. Yeah. I'm gonna go for a dry tomorrow and test the turn signal cam out and stuff, but the horn works and it looks pretty good, man. Yeah. I like it, fellas. Drop down in the comments. Tell me what y'all think, man. Thank y'all for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell notification so when y'all know exactly when I drop these hot videos, man. Y'all have a great day.